thing. But they all did really good.
Right, OK.
Yeah.
All right, thank you very much. Lovely talking to you, Rebecca. Hey, before you go, would you mind just listening to this for us?
Ibex, I don't know if you can remember me. We used to spend a lot of time together. Can you guess who this is?
Anthony from me!
You do know who that is, then?
Yes!
Yeah? All right, fantastic. You go over there with Daisy. Give her a big round of applause, please. Yeah!
Look at this, it's apparently Becca's most treasured possession. Look, it says it there, treasured possession. Okay, oh, Bex, can you explain this, please, love? What is it?
It's my V-Buck, like when I used to follow V.
Yeah.
And like, there's just loads of pictures. No, all my, like,
not travel all cards from travelling up and down to see
not
them?
Not all of them, because I haven't really kept them all, but there's a few.
How long did you follow these lot for?
For like a year.
Oh, look, here you are there with them. There's Anthony and you. A year you followed them.
Yeah.
Documented beautifully in this book. So, Bex, there may well be classified information in this book here, so I think we better get an official to adjudicate, OK? An official adjudicator. Could you please come in? Isn't that a brilliant TV moment, everybody? Bexy.
Oh my God, this is so weird! Oh,
back again, reunited.
Tell us what you did in the band. Obviously, Bex knows all too well.
Sang, danced, looked good. Not really. No,
yeah,
sorry.
Do you remember, Bex? I was going to say,
yeah, I do, yeah.
Point, but do you actually remember?
No, I do, yeah. She was everywhere, yeah. She knew where we was before
was
we did.
What was it like having such a super fan? Did you feel like, sure?
Yeah, I did, Jeff. Yeah, I did. I felt really strong. You made me feel really strong. Good about
world.
Myself.
Do you ever get a little bit scared though? A little bit intense, all of this stuff now?
Well,
you wanted that, didn't you?
You loved it, right? Yeah. Little pictures, ticket set, all that.
Flattering.
Sorry, busted
That's the no, these were supporting us.
Oh, okay, yeah. Fair enough.
Yeah. We went into the thing, and then we used to come out.
Okay. All right. Pictures. But Bex, what is this? Okay, what is this all about? I know what it is. I don't want to touch it, but I want you to explain, because I think it's shameful. Get it out.
It's just stuff that I've just kept, you know, because I'm really
cool. Yeah, but what's that? We know you've kept lots of stuff. What's that? Oh, let's get the branding out.
These are things that I used to find in my pocket.
My word.
That's actually Leon's half-eaten Mars Snickers bar.
And you kept it for how long? Who gave you that in
and
when?
And I think you gave me that, Anthony.
Oh, did
what's
I?
That?
It's a V.
A V sweet.
No, I just carry them around.
That's from 2004. Are you still not a little bit scared? Like, Harvey and chocolate.
It's just been in there. I haven't even touched it. It's just been in there ever since.
I just read eggs to your honour.
Someone offered me £25 for it at a concert.
£25?
Yeah, but I said I wanted it.
I'll have it then. Probably worth £100 now. What other scary things you got in here? Let's have a look.
Please don't.
Okay, should we not? I'll go on. There's only tickets and pictures, just all annotated beautifully.
Yeah, quality.
Beautiful,
like
just the dedication is astonishing. Magazine stuff.
Very kind of them.
Little hat thing.
What was that? That was from
V. You stood up.
You stood up and sold it out now. It's a little. I'm so cool.
You are so cool, Bex. How's it feel to be reunited with Anthony? I mean, you're like literally groping distance.
Oh, I really missed him. It was
really
good.
It's really great. Now, Bex, BBLB has got a challenge for you, madam, okay? We're not happy with just one band member. Anthony's great, but it's not enough, right? What we're going to do is reunite you with the entire band.
Wait.
We're going to get you to perform with them next week in this studio. You in V.
It is there?
Yeah, seriously, guys. Do you think you can do it? You're going to hunt them down, get them all together and perform with them. Can you do it?
Yeah?
Have you got the dedication? So awesome. But Bex, that's not all we got planned for you, okay? There's more. More this week. It's going to be great. Tomorrow, you are taking me on a homecoming tour of Coventry. You're taking me, okay?
Oh my God!
I've never been to Coventry. I'm excited. Are you up for it?
Oh my God, yeah.
Can you show me around?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, and get this on Tuesday. There's also more. We're off to Wigan to meet Luke's parents. Yes, again, I've never been to Wigan. I'm really excited. It's like a regional tour. How do you feel about that? Luke's parents, Tuesday, meet you,
Wigan.
Did they
say that was okay?
They can't wait. Oh my God. They can't wait. They're going to put on a nice spread for you, maybe do a roast. How do you feel?
Meeting the parents. It's going to be fun, huh? Now, that isn't the only thing.
Jack, this is your life.
It's crazy.
It's not the only thing that I've got planned there for Zazie, guys. Little surprise for you. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You know how much she loves Rex?
Yeah, I've said as much a lot.
I've organised for her to meet her nemesis, Rex's girlfriend, everybody. Missing her so much. So you've got a busy week ahead of you, girls. Join us after the break when Grace then will be passing her critics' eyes over the events in the house of the past week. See you in fall. Welcome back, everybody. It's day 53. The time is 28 minutes past. I don't know what's wrong with me and clocks today. We've just got time to take a last peek inside the house. Keith, what's happening in there, mate?
Luke just did a poo.
Lovely.
On the floor and raw with the poo. I miss Bex.
Wow, that's a true kind of tribute of love.
They're just sitting there measuring each other's hands.
Really? What does that mean if you've got big hands?
Big tallywhacker.
Right, OK. And what if you've got little hands?
Small tallywhacker.
OK, and what about Mikey then? Because he's not really playing, is he?
He ain't got a tallywhacker.
Right, no tallywhacker. Right, wow. What bad news for Mikey then. Hey, listen, Keith.
Yeah?
Keith, I think you should come back here. Bex is gagging to meet you.
Is she going to do Nuts magazine?
I don't know. You can ask her when you come back.
I hope so.
Yeah, we all hope so. We all hope so. Keith, come on back, mate.
Ta-da.
All right, mate.
Can't wait to see Keith back. Now, every week this lady sifts through Big Brother, the mine of it, to bring us diamonds for our viewing pleasure. It's our very own precious gem, Grace Dent, everyone.
Thank you. Hello.
Hello, lovely. How are you?
I'm very, very well.
Good. Now, Luke, you know, obviously he's had a lot on his mind since poor lovely Bex left. She's there.
Yes, he's
But you've noticed something that's been bothering him for a long time,
the troubles of Friday. The thing is, Sosie, I watch this show a lot. I watch it 24 hours a day, if I can, 7 days a week. Now, there is nobody in that house more obsessed with the £100,000 cheque than Luke. Can we have a little look at some...
Yeah, let's see this, guys.
So, I'm sorry, Bex, but look
have
at
a
this.
Look.
Oh, cat, probably goes about the £100,000 cheque at the end of the show.
Yeah, well, the guy is terrified he's not going to collect his £100,000 cheque at the end of this.
Believe me, it's nobody's £100,000 at this stage.
People have been voted out because they're a threat to the £100,000 cheque.
£100,000 is a lot of money. You can take your kids to Disney World then with £100,000. You can do a lot with £100,000. Everybody wants £100,000 in here.
It's a life-changing amount of money, £100,000.
She's only sorry she's trodding on all of us to get to a £100,000 cheque.
It's a race to who gets the £100,000 cheque for those two.
Yeah.
Depends how much she wanted £100,000. How much she really wanted the £100,000 there.
£100,000, Mike, what are you doing with your £100,000?
It's not looking good, is it, Bex?
No. Really. Bex, is it true that he's obsessed with the £100,000? Can you verify this? He says it a lot.
No, I think it's what it is. I think he's just saying it because that's how much other people want it.
I think in his head he's already...
I think he's already
mentally spent it on, like, fake tan and tickets to Cough to see you. So.
Cheap suits. Cinema tickets to treat his lady. What's going on there?
Well, I'm not sure. I think he just wants the money, doesn't he? She's not having that.
She's not having it. Now, you watch the web 24/7.
I do.
And Mario, bless him, not here, but he would be furious if he was still in the house because you witnessed a health and safety travesty
on Friday. Health and safety alert. Let's have a look at this.
What's that, Daniel? Good for the last minute female vote.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
They're not going to see today's one.
No, wait, I'll rub it off, Kat.
Why is it that hot? Sorry.
Oh my God!
I think this is a good example of why Mikey is maybe one of the most aggravating and opinionated people in the house because, like, whose decision is it whether that cup of coffee was hot? The person holding the boiling hot cup of coffee or the person that got it right down the back of their neck, from their neck right down to their pants. With Mikey, I do find him quite aggravating. I like
just
the way that, like...
because he shouts all the time!
Yeah, no, but he basically kind of spends all week accusing people of being loud and then when he goes into the diary room, he's the loudest thing on British television.
I just never really liked it.
Louder than the bongs on News at 10. Louder than a Red Arrow's fly past. So, like, bless him, but he is quite aggravating sometimes in his own little sweet way.
Now, there's something that's just actually perturbed me to read this. Yes. You're going to be...